Hi guys, this is Asal. I'm studying for the bar and I wanted to review my notes with you. So today I'm studying evidence and I'm studying the opinions and expert testimony. So it's actually very simple. All you need to know is that for a person to be able to testify, they must have personal knowledge of what they're testifying about. This means that a person must be competent to testify. But there are certain instances that a person wasn't necessarily at the scene and they don't necessarily have personal knowledge. So that's where expert testimony comes in, and I'm going to talk about that in just a second. But first of all, I would like to talk about lay opinions. So there's three elements to that. It must be helpful to facilitate, based on perception, and finally, non-specialized. So under the lay opinions, the person doesn't necessarily have to be specialized or have a specific skill or education. This is where you distinguish it with expert testimony, where they have to have the education or the specialized skills. So over here, the elements of expert testimony is it must be helpful to facilitate, based on sufficient facts, reliable methods, and finally, reliable application. So the reliable methods comes out of the Daubert case, and it requires the testability, peer review, error rule, there's that error rule, right? And finally, professional standards and acceptance. So to summarize, I would like you to know that the lay opinions comes from the rule 701 and 702. Remember that. Rule 701 talks about helpful, perceived, and specialized. Rule 704 talks about an ultimate issue. And then with the expert testimony, you want to look at the qualifications and the special knowledge. And you want to look at the rule 702, which is helpful, sufficient, and reliable. And you also want to look at the rule 703 and 705, which is underlying facts and data. So remember that for the evidence, expert testimony and opinion testimony, those fall under the rule 701 all the way through the rule 705. That's where you get your rules from. So now that I talked about my rules a little bit and I told you where to go to look up your rules, I would like to talk about this rule a little bit and show you the exam tips over here. So right over here, as you can see, this book gives some exam tips. It's very useful, so I use them all the time. I would like to start with the lay opinions. Over here, it says that the threshold issue is when a non-expert, that's the key word, witness is testifying to what appears to be an opinion. So you want to examine these two thresholds. The first one, you want to make sure it really is an opinion. So make sure it's an opinion, not just some other evidence such as like reputation. And then finally, you want to make sure that is made in court. So check that the statement is made in court. Finally, over here, there's two requirements for non-expert witnesses to testify. The first one is rationally based on the perception of the witness, and the second one, helpful to clear understanding of the witness testimony or determination of the fact and issue, the rule 701 that I just talked about. And then the next thing I would like to talk about is what is commonly tested. So over here it has a tip that it says where a witness can't easily state underlying facts, look for the witness's sense impression or the witness's perceptions of someone else's or something else's appearance. So you want to look at those facts. And then finally, look for the lack of opportunity to perceive. This book says that that's another common trap. So don't fall into those traps. It says that the witness didn't have a sufficient opportunity to perceive the elements on which her opinion is based. So remember that. There's some examples here. One of the examples is, for example, if the witness hears a screeching sound made by one car involved in an accident but didn't actually see the car. Okay, so there's no seeing, but then he heard the screeching sound. And then the next thing I would like to talk about is the expert opinions. So it says over here that expert testimony is allowed where scientific, technical, or other specialized knowledge will help the trier of the fact either one, understand the evidence, Two, to determine a fact and issue. This is FRE 702 that I just talked about. So look for the technical issues, look for the fact pattern where the witness is talking about some technical issue. And also, finally, look for appropriate expert testimony. They have to be the appropriate ones, because if it's inappropriate, then it won't work. And then finally, look for the basis of the expert opinion. So it says that opinion may be based on the witness's personal knowledge of the fact, two, facts presented in the courtroom in the form of hypotheticals, or facts told to the witness outside the courtroom and not in evidence, as long as they are of a type reasonably relied on by the expert in a particular field. So that's the rule FRE 703. And then finally, the most frequently tested is an opinion based on material, not in evidence. It says, crap, the material relied on is inadmissible, usually hearsay. So this doesn't matter. And then finally, I would like to talk about the ultimate issue. So look for an opinion on an ultimate issue or fact, and scientific tests and principles. So that's pretty much everything I wanted to talk about. I really hope you enjoy studying evidence. Good luck.